Hey guys, it's Gary with Upton Base here. We get a lot of questions on a day-to-day basis. What's the difference between a standard and a deluxe top? Well, here we have a deluxe top. Well, what's becoming a deluxe top? A standard top, essentially, you take an instrument, like a top like this, after the top is joined, two pieces of spruce on their thick side, the bookmatch spruce is joined, we get the general shape to the top, and the graduation throughout ends up being around 8-9 millimeters. Again, unless the piece of wood is very flexible, we might go a little bit more robust. If it's a very robust piece of wood, we might go a little bit thinner. But typically, the standard level instruments, where they're being used and who's using them, and also the type of sound they're going after, we don't want to go too frail on those bases. Here you have a deluxe top, and not only is it 8 and 9 millimeters, but it's also thicker in areas, like under the sound post. We move out in this kind of this bullseye-esque shape here. Again, I've just thrown that on there for illustration purposes for you guys. But you know, you've got 8 millimeters through here on this particular piece of wood, 6 up here. I'm going to be at 7 here, 6 here. Again, that's not my graduation pattern per se. It is for this piece of wood based on its flexibility, its feel, you know, the grain orientation, and also tap tones we go after. You'll see for illustrative purposes, again, I've drawn on the neck block where it lines up with the instrument at the top here. You know, we'll fare that all out because we want the neck block, the rib assembly, and all that stuff to really sit flat together. We're not going to force that together. That creates bases of crack. It's a lot of what, nearly all of what I see being imported from a lot of the low price point carved instruments. Yeah, they're carved and they're smashed together. Here you'll also see on the deluxe top, there's a big flat section through here by the end pin block. The idea with that, it's almost an interior version of what we do on the tops of the deluxe bases, where you'll see that French cello purfling, that French purfling style going through. We leave the neck block area on the outside thicker there. This is going after the thought process of reducing saddle cracks. You know, giving that little bit more thickness and rigidity down here to such a high impact area and a high strength based area, it just makes logical sense to us. And we've been doing that now for years, and I've seen that. What I think really helps result in stronger instruments, and it doesn't have a negative impact on the sound. If anything, the contrary, I think it really does add a certain element. So these plunge hole depths we do on the drill press. Those are all set at varying thicknesses for the top, so that then when I'm working up through here, you see a few of them disappearing. But the idea is, so that as we're working through here, you know, kind of down to tolerance. Then we'll use the natural light to see if we're too low as it's coming in from outside, and you know, really fare these areas in together. So that's what goes into a deluxe top. After we do this all by hand, with the different planes, we'll actually use a scraper and get this all cleaned out, make it, you know, beautiful, get it ready for its base bar, which we don't put in with any tension again. And that's a deluxe top. I mean, purfling, the lipping on the outside, all of that recurve and all of that elegance we put into making the instruments. But this is really the engine behind a deluxe top. One thing I wanted to add, if you're looking at the top dimension of the instrument and you're seeing that, you know, it's already cut out, you might say, oh, is it prefabricated or something from another shop? No. We get the instrument to as close to its shape as possible. As I was trying to illustrate, this is Brad Helene's Breschen Deluxe bass here. So just showing you, you know, how we've got it. I mean, it's close, but it's not really close. So the idea is for us to know we've got the top to as close as possible while we're graduating it. You know, I just wanted to add that in case anyone saw it and said, oh my goodness, you know, look, the top's already the shape of a bass. Yeah, it is. We did that. We just cut them out. So anyhow, just wanted to clarify. If anyone has any questions, give us a call. We're happy to share. See you guys.